Hello, Sarah from the Bureau with your weekly weather update, where I'll be touching on the clearing cold front for southeastern Australia and the developing severe weather for New South Wales and Queensland with a potential east coast low. But we'll start off taking a look at the satellite imagery where we see this well-defined cold front that brought the heavy rainfall and damaging winds to the southeast over the last couple of days. Now that is moving out into the Tasman Sea, dragging with it that severe weather, with a trough pushing up the east coast of New South Wales today, bringing showers and storms to the eastern half and also pushing up into Queensland as well. Now this high pressure system out here in the west extends a ridge into central and western parts, bringing dry and sunny conditions. And as we move into tomorrow, just keeping an eye on that trough out in the east, it pushes up into Queensland, bringing showers and thunderstorms across central and southern parts, with even the potential for heavy rainfall about southeastern parts of Queensland. That high in the Bight continuing to bring settled and clear conditions across the south and central parts, apart from in the southeast with an onshore flow just bringing a few showers there. Now on Thursday, the weather with the showers and storms really ramp up over eastern parts of the country due to an approaching upper level trough combining with a deep layer of moist onshore flow. Now we're forecasting showers and storms through central and southern Queensland and through eastern parts of New South Wales as well, with widespread moderate to heavy rainfall possible through the region. Now it's on Friday, however, that coastal trough starts to deepen with the potential for an east coast low to develop off the east coast of New South Wales. And that may bring damaging winds, heavy rainfall and dangerous surf to much of the coastal area. And just noticing that we're still extending a ridge in through the central part, so remaining to be pretty much fine and clear through there. Now it's on Saturday that coastal low starts to skirt southwards, dragging with it the heavy rainfall and the damaging winds into the southern coast and Illawarra and even potentially parts of far eastern Victoria as well. Now temperature wise, it's fairly mild right across southern Australia, temperatures in the low 20s in the wake of that cold front, much warmer as we go north, 29 degrees forecast maximum for today. And tomorrow, even cooler in the southeast, Hobart, a top of just 15 degrees, 17 for Melbourne, out in the west, far warmer and 31 degrees for Perth. As we move towards the end of the week though, really mild conditions dominate across eastern Australia underneath that cloud band with all that rain, keeping the temperatures down, continuing into Friday as well. So that's it for this week's weekly forecast. Now with the school holidays being on, it's really important that if you live or you're planning a holiday across eastern parts of the country, to stay up to date with the Bureau's forecasts and warnings via the Bureau website, app and social media. And if you are going on holidays, change your location on the Bureau app so that you receive those push notifications for any warnings. Bye for now.